Hi guys, it's Dan and John from PI Engineering, and we got another little tutorial for you. We had kind of a cool announcement this week in that Trains A New Era, or TANE, their new version they announced has rail driver support in it. So what's the deal, John? They've got support for our controls.
Yes, the main throttles, brakes, all that works fine, but I've had a couple of people email me and send me messages on Facebook that the D-pad and the horn doesn't work. So I'm going to show everyone how to program those.
So the horn's this guy up here.
Right here, and the D-pad down here. And you can also, for future reference, if you want to make keyboard shortcuts, programming the D-pad is the same as programming these buttons here. So
once you show us how to do this,
you can also program these because it's the same concept.
Okay, so here's our desktop.
All right, you're going to want to launch MacroWorks. If you can't find it, you can always go to your search pad. It should download automatically when you download the drivers for RailDriver. And the nice thing about it is that it actually looks like the controller up on your screen. So let's start with the D-pad. We'll just click this one here.
So each one of those four little buttons has their own, can be programmed to do something else.
Well, you could program them to do something else, but yes, they're each their own individual. We're doing the up arrow right now.
Okay.
So we'll go to, this window will pop up once you double click that. Go to keystrokes and we're recording. Make sure you do check this box here.
That's separate press and release.
Yes.
Yep.
And then it's as simple as press the up arrow on your keyboard. And there we go. And then we'll click save it. And then we'll just repeat that for all of them. Left arrow and left arrow on the keyboard.
And as you said, you could click on any one of these buttons on the rail driver and assign a keystroke to it.
Yes, if you have hotkeys in the game, I'm not familiar with all of them, but let's say we wanted to program, I don't know, the letter H. There we go.
There you go. Yep.
We're not going to, but.
But that's how you program the other buttons.
Yes, you can do F keys. Anything you can put on a keyboard, you can put on here. Down arrow. There we go. Save. That one's programmed now for the D-pad. Now for the horn. Same thing. It is the H button normally, but we'll program H here. And there's also two, so if you want to press up, click that one. If you want to press down, same thing, we'll do H.
Yeah, that horn lever is actually two switches, one on the up and one on the down.
Correct.
Normally, you want them both to fire the same keystroke, but.
And we'll go ahead, go to File, Close GUI. And now let's test it out. I got the British locomotive loaded up here. Game's paused. And let's see if it works.
Here, I'll show this you. This is what you're doing. You're pressing on this. And then as you're pressing those controls, we're navigating around in the game.
Yep, now let's test the horn. Yep, and that is good to go.
Okay.
And it's as simple as that. And like I said, if you want to program the rest of these little buttons, you can do the same thing, same concept. Just choose your shortcut.
RailDriver.com is where to find more information and buy a RailDriver if you don't have one already. And tech@RailDriver.com is how to contact us if you're having issues or if you need some help setting it up. And our new Facebook page, RailDriver PI, come join us. You know, we're looking for followers, and if we get a few more, we'll probably start up a user group.
We will.
All right. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you next time.